Alright, so there you go, the Husqvarna Vitpilen 401. So before we start, I've actually been eyeing this bike way before I even got my Svartpilen. But like most of you guys, I was also a bit hesitant if I can handle or pretty much daily such an aggressive looking bike with its TE's Poggy or Cafe Racer stance over its much comfier and safer looking Svartpilen counterpart. So yeah, today I'm just gonna discuss with you guys how it feels to ride after having it for 1 week and to find out if I made the mistake of buying the Svartpilen over the Vitpilen 401. This will only be a quick review on how the bike handles and what are the similarities and differences that it has with its brother, and that is because this bike shares almost 90% of its parts with its Scrambler counterpart. So if you want to learn more technical aspects about the bike, kindly watch my in-depth video of the Svartpilen 200. So now let's start with the similarities of the Svartpilen and the Vitpilen. Okay, so first things first, these two bikes look practically the same. They share almost the exact same parts, from the LED headlights, signal lights, tail lights, side mirrors, body frames, engine, dual ABS, quick shifter, instrument cluster, and suspension. And literally, the only difference that they have is, first, the color. The Svartpilen has this dark greenish look, while the Vitpilen has this silver matte finish, which I kinda lean more towards too. The Vitpilen doesn't have the bag rack on the tank. Plus, the Vitpilen also has this slightly different muffler design and foot pegs position, obviously because of its Cafe Racer stance compared to the Svartpilen's relaxed Scrambler design. And of course, there are major differences such as the Vitpilen's 17-inch 5-spokes alloy wheels with Metzeler's slick tires. Compare that to the Svartpilen's 8-spokes mag wheels with dual sport tires. And of course, the raised handlebar of the Svartpilen versus the low clip-ons on the Vitpilen Cafe Racer. And then there's the price. The Vitpilen is priced at 315,000, while the Svartpilen 401 is priced at 295,000, and the 200 version of the Svartpilen, which the Vitpilen does not have, cost 175,000 pesos. But what about the riding differences? And like I said, I had this bike for almost a week and I took it to places like Tagaytay and the notoriously bad traffic of EDSA. I mean, this bike has clip-ons and angled footrests, like most sports bikes, so the riding position is kinda hunched forward and downwards, which gives it that low and aggressive look that is perfect for riding in highways and the twisties. So if you're used to riding sports bikes, then you wouldn't have a problem with this Vitpilen. But obviously, with great looks comes with a little bit of slight discomfort. And this is why most casual buyers stay away from it. Because as we all know, clip-ons or this kind of aggressive stance puts a lot of strain on your neck, back, and especially your wrists. Slightly longer rides like the one we did in Tagaytay definitely put a strain on those parts, especially on my neck, because naturally my body is looking downwards but my neck is looking straight forward. But then again, Tagaytay is an uphill and downhill ride, so it will exert more strain to your wrist compared to when you're riding it on a flat highway. For me, the strain is not so much on the wrist because I can kinda control it with my legs or thighs by simply wrapping it around the tank and then lifting some of the weight off from my wrist and to my lower body. So yeah, that's one way of lessening the burden that you otherwise won't have with its counterpart, the Svartpilen. I mean, it's not really that bad. It's uncomfortable but bearable, especially in shorter rides, and on longer rides, you just need to take more stops and breaks. But it's definitely something that you could get used to or learn. I'd say most beginner riders or casual riders will definitely feel that stress, but the more you're riding it and the more you learn about its riding dynamics, then the less painful it gets. Riding performance-wise, the Vitpilen is slightly faster and more stable, possibly because of its grippier tires and lower center of gravity, so less air resistance, especially on highways. And on traffic, with the clip-ons, this bike is easier to maneuver, but a little bit less stable compared to the Svartpilen. But just like any other bike, this Vitpilen has its pros and cons. For example, obviously this bike looks extremely good, and is even rarer or less common than the Svartpilen. So there's no doubt that you'll definitely stand out on a sea of bikes that all look the same. And sadly, just like any other bike, there are definitely some cons on this bike as well. Other than the riding comfort, this bike sadly cannot go off-road compared to its Svartpilen counterpart. And also, this bike is not really meant to carry a pillion or a back ride. I mean, it can, but it's not really meant for it because of its aggressive stance. And if I were to change one thing about this bike, it will probably be the side mirrors. I'd most likely put bar ends on it, like with what I did with my Svart. But overall, I kinda have mixed feelings with this bike. I kinda want it because of its looks, but I also kinda don't because of the cons that it comes with. I mean, those cons aren't really a deal breaker for me, but for some, it is. I feel like this bike is definitely not for everyone. I mean, don't get me wrong, this is a fun weekend bike that you can take on the track and maybe on coffee rides and meetups, but it's not as comfortable and versatile as the Svartpilen, which you can pretty much ride every day on a daily basis. You really need to want the look of the bike, because I feel like this bike is meant for those who really want to look good while riding and dress and ride apart. So there you go, same bike but two completely different riding styles. One is a scrambler that you can pretty much ride every day, while the other is a cafe racer inspired bike that is best suited for weekend rides, stylish coffee rides, and on the racetrack. So the final question is, did I regret getting my Svart over the Vitpilen? And the answer is a yes and a no. Yes, because I partly still prefer the looks of the Vitpilen, but also no, because I want to get more out of my bike. And obviously the Svartpilen can go places where the Vitpilen can't, and it can do it much more comfortably. So there you go, a quick first impressions of the Vitpilen. And if you guys want to see more bike reviews and comparisons, definitely hit the like and subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.